Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly readings. I know we are a bit behind. It's been extremely crazy. I hope all of you guys are staying safe. And let's get into the reading, Virgos. This is your reading, Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus for the month of May 2020. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for this month. Spirits, what are the messages? Please give me Virgo's business and finances card for this month of May. All right, Virgos, you have the Ten of Swords. So the Ten of Swords could represent for some of you guys concluding or coming to a conclusion in regards to your finances. For some of you guys, it could be concluding a project. For others, if you were working like temporarily or something like that, it's finally coming to a conclusion. Now, for those of you guys that have been laid off or have been without a job for a while because you're not considered an essential worker, that's finally coming to its conclusion. You're going to be able to move forward in a very positive way because the Ten of Swords signifies the worry or the burden or the difficulty is finally coming to its end, and we're starting a new beginning, a new endeavor. So positive card, although it may be, it may seem bleak, it's very positive because that difficulty that we need to overcome has come to its conclusion, okay? All right, in regards to communication, how you will be communicating for this month, you have the Six of Cups. So the Six of Cups could be dealing with a lot of people from your past. This could be reconnecting with people. I see you guys reconnecting like on social media. So it could be people reaching out to you. It could be that people are finding you on social media and communication happens. They're like trying to, I see a lot of people coming back from the past. And I see you being floored. So it could be a situation that arises where you thought there was like an ending or some type of conclusion. And then out of nowhere, they come back around and they try to contact you or they try to communicate with you. This could have something to do with the person that perhaps you were emotionally invested in or like emotionally attached to that comes out of the blue. Like you thought that was done, dealt with. And then they pop back around and you're like, you're floored. You're like, oh my God, I never thought that this person would like reach out or that I would hear from them again. So I think more than anything, it's feeling like a beautiful surprise for some of you guys. So that's definitely a good thing. Now, in regards to your obstacle to overcome for this month, you have the King of Swords. So you may be dealing with an air energy, Aquarius, Gemini, Libra. This could also represent like an authority. So this could be your supervisor. This could be a in your family dynamic. This could be like a parent. Doesn't have to be the father figure. It could be a female figure as well. It is a general reading. But I see that the obstacle here has more to do with your belief system, Virgo. So when I say your belief system, I feel that in regards to what you're currently going through, there's almost like a need of like to have or attain a maturity type of level to be able to fully take advantage of these new opportunities that are coming to you. And when I say new opportunities, this is directly speaking about love and finances. So my advice to you, Virgo, if you start to get the up and up when it comes to having good luck or when it comes to really being able to make money, be smart about it is what they're saying. Be methodical in the way you spend your money. And the reason for that is because I do see you having like this streak of good luck. But as we all know, streak of good lucks do run their course. So just be smart about the way you spend your money, okay? All right, spirits, please give me the card that represents their love and romance for this month of May. All right, so you have the Empress card. Empress card, you may be dealing with a Venusian type of energy. This could be a Libra. This can also represent, I see a lot of people really looking to you, like admiring you, whether it's like, in regards to finances, like if you've kind of like gone up the ladder in a very quick time, I see a lot of people wanting to like really get your attention. And they're seeing you as a very like prosperous type of energy. Now, the thing to keep in mind here is, again, if you have gone from like not having enough to being abundant, be smart about the people around you. And the reason I say that is because with the King of Swords and the Empress, it could represent people being attracted to what you seem to possess, meaning on a physical aspect, and the physical aspect is that of the material. So if you're often talking about like having and flaunting, then people are going to be attracted to you based off what you're showing, based off what you have. And you don't want those type of that type of energy, because ultimately it brings leeches to you. Okay? And this could even represent, Virgo, like friends, people around you that you trust or that you often like take care of, or you're like, oh, I got you, till it gets to the point where you're frustrated because you're like, what the hell, I'm not gonna like have you all the time, in regards to like looking out for them. And I feel that people get comfortable with that, and you ultimately have no one to blame but yourself, because you are either constantly talking about what you have or constantly making it seem like you're not, like, it could have to do with immaturity as well. But I feel that, like, people around you could be around you because out of the benefit of what they can attain from you. So be careful with that. Now, like I said, for some of you guys, this could represent a new energy coming through for this month of May that is trying to get your attention or trying to, like, go out of their way to like seduce you in a sense. Be careful with that, because they are telling me that there is something that has to do with that of like what they can gain from you. And if you can look at the Empress, we have a bunny down here, and that to me is fertility. So it could be like leeches, like women that try to get babies from guys, you know, or vice versa, guys that are trying to impregnate women to have them like supposedly get them stuck with them. Just be careful, okay, of the people that surround you, Virgo. And funny, your spirit's message here is envy. Be careful of the people that you are around, even those that may seem to be cheering you on. Are they cheering you on? Because the more they cheer you on, the more you take care of them, the more you look out for them, the more you help them. Or is it people that genuinely don't expect anything from you and that love you and support you? You need to learn how to differentiate that type of energy, Virgo. Envy card usually indicates to me a person that is within your inner circle that is a frenemy, someone that pretends to be a friend, but they're very quick to stab you in the back, or they're very quick to see what they can get from you, even, you know, at the cost of friendship. So be careful with that, Virgo. All right, my lovelies, I hope that you guys, I hope this gives you clarity. I hope that you and your loved ones and your family are, you know, being safe. Take care of yourselves, and we'll see each other soon. Till then, bye.